Welcome. Today, I will elaborate on how to move from analysis to synthesis. Or in other words, from form, operation, and actual performance to desired performance, operation, and form. This will help you learn from the case of Vauban district, Freiburg in Germany, or from Vasta Hamnen, the national example of sustainable urban development in Malmö, Sweden, or any other example to come to solutions for your own environment. Analysis is reasoning forwards. We first of all study the form or morphology of the so-called entity, in our case the urban environment. We then look how the form facilitates operation and as a result of operation what the actual performance is. This all takes place within a specific geographical and cultural context. Synthesis is reasoning backwards. It starts with looking at the context and the desired performance of the entity. How should the entity operate in order to achieve this performance? And what form is needed to facilitate this operation? Let me illustrate these elements by using a metaphor of an elephant. Form is about both the shape and structure of the elephant. On the left, you see the overall shape. The image on the right shows the underlying structural features of the elephant. So there are various ways of defining form. Operation of the elephant depends on the needs that have to be fulfilled. For example, to clean its eye, he uses his proboscis. To crack a melon, his leg is needed. Various tools are needed to operate. See here the difference between an elephant transporting a heavy piece of military equipment or running freely in nature. The actual performance of an elephant very much depends on the context. Let us now take a look at the context of our study. In the geographical context of an urban environment, several factors are relevant, such as climate, soil conditions, and high-risk situations. The Dutch Delta, to a large extent, lies beneath the sea level, as you can see here in green, in the image on the left. The image on the right clearly shows the urban areas that would be underwater. Looking at the cultural context, other factors play a role, like norms and values and social interactions. Also, the planning system is relevant, as you can see here. The separation between slums and high-rise buildings leads to social segregation. Focusing on form, the shape and structure of cities are the topic of study. These can be studied on various levels and scales. Let me explain. The scales to consider can vary from global level to material level. In this case, we look at the level of cities. Cities have important spatial features at different scales, ranging from the metropolitan scale and the regional scale to the city scale, zooming in to the neighborhood and street level. A city is also called a multi-level entity. In addition to these various spatial scales, it has several interacting levels with regards to management, culture, economy, technique, and ecology. When you look at how a city operates, you can see that it's at the same time both subject to relatively slow and fast changes. Slow changes refer to the growth and shrinkage of a city, caused by extensions, new infrastructures, urban transformations, and planned and unplanned developments. Here you can see the transformation over time of Schipluiden, a small village in the Netherlands. Fast changes refer, for example, to pedestrian flows, as you can see here from two different starting points in the inner city of Delft. In red, we see the most crowded areas. Fast changes also refer to other traffic modalities and urban metabolism, such as energy, information, nutrients, materials, and goods. The metabolism of a city increases with its size. Please realize that with animals the opposite occurs. Small animals, like mice, have a higher metabolism compared to big ones, like elephants. Let me now elaborate on how the desired performance of the city can be related to city form. Kevin Lynch translated what he calls good city form into six dimensions: vitality, sense, fit, access, control, and efficiency and justice. The five indicators distinguished by Claudio Fogaci focus on urban form resilience, are spatial integration, interscalarity, centrality, interconnectedness, and extra capacity. The link between form, operation, and actual performance is presented in several theories on cities, albeit implicitly. Let me give you two examples. Space syntax, a method on how urban space networks relate to socio-economic characteristics, is multi-level and multi-scale. Form, it deals with both urban transformations and traffic intensities, velocities, and many other factors, operation, and is about social, economic, and cognitive performances. In the second example, several indicators show that the pace of social life in cities increases with its population size. We see here the velocity of pedestrians in relation to population size. Social life can be expressed in terms of rates of innovation, wealth creation, patterns of consumption, human behavior, and properties of urban infrastructure. Now you understand the two different reasoning schemes. Please use these schemes to synthesize and find advanced metropolitan solutions. I challenge you to start looking at the desired performance in your own specific context. Please ask yourself which form and operation facilitate sustainable urban development.